Welcome to Soaping 101. This week, it's all about olive oil soaps, or in proper terms, Castile soap, said to be named after the Kingdom of Castile in Spain. True Castile soap consists of 100% olive oil. Not all olive oils are created equal. While all are made from olives, oils vary by region, variety of olives, species of olive tree, climate, growing conditions, you get the idea. But one thing is common amongst all traditional olive oil producers. The processing methods are the same. The olives are harvested, then washed. Well, let me just show you. Here we have 24 ounces of washed and pitted olives, green and black variety. The third step in the process is to grind them into a pulp. In the processing plant, this is done with large stone wheels or steel drums, but we'll use a food grinder. Once the pulp is finely mashed, we need to squeeze out the oil. Many olive oil makers will use a hydraulic press, but we're going to use a coffee press. It takes a bit of heavy pressure to expel the oil. Or we can put the pulp into a nylon stocking and squeeze the heck out of it. What we have here is pure olive oil mixed with water and paste remnants. You can clearly see the oil slick floating on top. Because oil and water don't mix, we can put this in our oil separator and wait until the mixture settles and the oil rises to the top. Can you see the separation in this image? My way is a pretty raw way of making olive oil, but it gives you a good idea of the simple steps involved. Grading of the oil is based on the processing methods used. There are four types. The first one is virgin, It's the first pressing of the oils with no chemicals, no heat, and no refinement. The second is refined. It is obtained by refining virgin olive oil that may not have been up to par. The third is olive oil, and it consists of a blend of virgin and refined olive oil. And lastly, pomace. This is the pulp that is left over after processing and has been treated with solvents to extract the remaining oil. So what does this mean in soap making? Well, a little and a lot. Castile can be made with any grade as long as it is 100% olive oil. The type of oil used will affect a few factors, one being trace. Higher grade olive oils take longer to reach trace, whereas pomace is quick to trace, and it contains a higher level of unsaponable fractions. In easy terms, there are more small amounts of olive oil that do not become mixed with the lye, making for a moisturizing bar of soap. Let's make some Castile soap. We can't choose our vegetable, but we can choose the grade. So our recipe has equal amounts of virgin, olive oil, and pomace. You'll notice a difference in the color intensity. After we give them a blend, we will add our lye solution, which is also at room temperature. Now, let's see how fast this will reach trace. Please note that I have fast-forwarded this part of the video. Our trace time was about 3 minutes with continual electric blending. Not too bad. In the mold it goes. Because of the longer blending time, I have more air bubbles than normal. So we'll add a portion, tab out the bubbles, and add some more. And we are done. That's all there is to Castile soap. But let's give ours a little more pizzazz with our mica oil trick. After setting up for 24 hours, our Castile soap is easily unmolded and cut. Now, all that's left to do is to wait 4 to 6 months before we can use it. Yep, Castile soap benefits from a long cure time. Can you use it before 6 months? Of course you can, but it is much harder, more lathering, and conditioning if you wait out the cure time. And have you been wondering just how much olive oil are 24 ounces of olives produced? Well, about 1/4 teaspoon. Well, that's it for this week. If you want to get your fill of all things soaping, head on over to our new Facebook group chat. Have fun with your classmates. I'll add the link below. Next week, we are making soap for skin conditions. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next week.